President-elect Joe Biden on the eve of his inauguration and the powerful moment that played out just moments ago. The President-elect Joe Biden and the Vice President-elect Kamala Harris now in Washington, pausing to reflect and to honor the American families forever changed, the more than 400,000 American lives now lost to the coronavirus. Lights along the National Mall honoring the victims in this worsening pandemic. President-elect Biden saying, "Let us shine the lights in the darkness along the sacred pool of reflection and remember who we lost." He is just hours away from the presidency with a nation in crisis like no other president in modern history has faced. The pandemic, the cratering economy, the long overdue reckoning on race, and the deadly siege at the Capitol. Tonight, his farewell in Delaware, growing emotional, speaking of his late son, and what we're learning about his inaugural address, how he hopes to unite the nation. President Trump's final hours in the White House, releasing a message, praising his achievements. And after telling his supporters to be strong, to fight, to march on the Capitol, in his parting message, condemning the attack. And without mentioning Joe Biden by name, he said, "We pray for the new administration's success." The president now planning his own military-style farewell for tomorrow morning, a 21-gun salute. And we have learned the Vice President Mike Pence will not be attending that farewell and that he will be at Joe Biden's inauguration. Tonight, the nation's capital on lockdown, 25,000 National Guard members in the capital. At news tonight, at least a dozen guardsmen now relieved of duty. What authorities found. The pandemic tonight and the vaccine from New York to Michigan to California and across this country. The concern over not enough vaccine and that it's not being administered quickly enough. Tonight, New York City's mayor saying the city will be out of vaccine by week's end. And America Strong tonight, the nurse, and tonight her performance, the nation watching.
From ABC News World Headquarters in New York, this is World News Tonight with David Muir.
Good evening, and it's great to have you with us here on this Tuesday night, on this eve of the inauguration, the final hours of Donald Trump's presidency. President-elect Joe Biden will take the oath tomorrow. He has dreamed.